Who was the only man to be sworn in as president of the U.S. by his father? You'll find out as one of these three contestants wins the chance to drive home in this brand new Pontiac Firebird Formula in just a 12 seconds. And now, here's the star of our show, Monty Hall.
Good audience. Thank you very much. Contestants, welcome to our show. This is Split Second. We enjoy doing the show and hope that you have a lot of fun playing along with our players and see how great you are. That was an interesting question at the beginning of the show. Who was sworn in as president by his father? People are thinking about maybe John Adams, John Quincy Adams. No, the answer was Calvin Coolidge, and here's how it happened. Silent Cal was visiting his dad in 1923 when the news came of President Harding's death. And Cal's dad was a justice of the peace, and he swore him in as president right there and then. A little interesting piece of Americana for all of you today. And now let's meet some interesting people here who are going to be three new contestants playing on Split Second, because the last person won a car just like that. Cars have been going like hotcakes. Maybe yours is next. Who are these three people, Sandy?
Well, Monty, first we have a writer of greeting card verses. But not the roses or red, violets, or blue variety. Meet Glenn Titan. Not to pay his squash club dues in cash, Sam Elfassi. And on your right, a lady with a passion for playing poker, Ellen Litton.
I don't know about the greeting cards and the squash players, but send me that poker player.
I have my own cards. I'm ready to go.
Oh, you bring your own cards? And she'll bring her own greeting cards. Okay, we're ready to play Split Second. Let me tell you how we play the game. As you know, there are three answers to each question. That makes us different. But I want only one answer from each of our players. If all three of you give me a correct answer, it's worth $10 to each. If only two of you come up with an answer, it's worth $25 each. If only one of you comes up with an answer to these questions, then it's going to be worth $50 in the first round. You buzz in as soon as you see the full question on the screen, but not till then. You buzz in too fast to try and get an advantage. You lock yourself out and have to go last. So here we go with our first question. Shall we speak English? I mean British English. I'll give you three very, very British words, and you tell me what they mean in American English. Look at the screen. Draughts and sultanas in full stop. Sam?
Draught is beer.
No, it is not. Thank you, Othello. Glenn?
Sultanas are cigarettes.
Glenn, did you answer?
Yes.
And you said sultana was cigarettes? Yes. That's not right. Ellen?
Draughts, I believe, are dominoes.
No, close. No. Close, but
checkers?
No. Now you say checkers. And now you know what you get? Nothing. Sultanas are raisins, and full stop means period. Now Ellen knew them all afterward. Well, now that you got the nervousness out of the way, let's settle down to a real tight game here. If you or anybody you know wants to send their children to a major university, they better know what city it's in. So here are three Ivy League schools. Pick one and name the city in which you'll find that university. Look at the screen. Yale, Cornell, and Harvard. Glenn.
Cornell's in New York.
The city?
New York City.
No, sorry, that's not right. Sam?
Harvard is in Boston.
Actually, it's Cambridge, which is a suburb of Boston, and I'm going to accept it because it's part of Boston proper. Ellen?
Yale, is that Hartford, Connecticut?
No, close. Again, New Haven, Connecticut, and Cornell's in Ithaca, New York. At least Cambridge was inside Boston. Okay, so one person gets it, and that's Sam. He gets a whole $50 off himself. You don't have to be a doctor to know that dermatitis is a skin problem. And you don't have to be a doctor to tell me what specific parts of the body are affected by these three ailments. Pick one and tell me what part of the body is affected. Angina, pneumonia, hepatitis. Sam?
Angina, heart.
Correct. Ellen?
Pneumonia, chest or lungs.
Right. Glenn?
Hepatitis, liver.
All three right. All three get $10. If you went shopping for fruit and asked for the following fruits, what specific fruits would you be buying? Look at the screen. The Seckel, the Cadota, and the Damson. Ellen.
Damson is a peach.
Sorry. Sam.
Cadota, tangerine.
Sorry. Glenn.
Cadota, pear.
Why isn't that interesting? All three of you wrong. But wait till you hear what they are. Seckel is a pear. Cadota is a fig. Ellen knew it again, didn't you? Ellen, you're the best runner-up I've had today. And Damson is plums. And no score over there. I get the biggest kick of looking over at Ellen. As soon as the question's over, she gives me all the answers. Okay. Ricky Lee Jones, Jack Jones, and Tom Jones have all had top 20 hits. I'll give you the titles of three of these hits. Pick one and tell me if it was a hit from Ricky Lee, Jack, or Tom Jones. Look at the screen. Wives and Lovers, Chucky's in Love, It's Not Unusual. Glenn.
Chucky's in Love, Ricky Lee Jones.
That is correct. Sam.
It's Not Unusual. No.
You should have taken a guess. Ellen.
Jack Jones, Wives and Lovers.
That's right, and It's Not Unusual from Tom Jones. Glenn and Ellen are right, get $25 each. Jonah, Job, and Jude have a book of the Bible named after them, but do these three famous biblical men have a book named after them too? Look at the screen. Yes or no? Do they have a book named after them? Abraham, David, and Paul? Sam.
Abraham, yes.
Not right. Ellen.
David, no.
That is correct. Glenn?
Paul, yes.
No, Paul, no. Abraham, no. David, no. All three, no. And only Ellen knew that it was no. This time, you knew it in time. She gets the whole $50 and takes over the lead in the game. If you're in Kenya standing on the equator, are the following countries north or south of where you're standing? Look at the screen. Sri Lanka, Philippines, and Australia. Are these countries north or south? Sam?
Philippines, south.
Wrong. Ellen?
Sri Lanka, south.
Wrong. Glenn?
Australia, south.
You're the only one who got that one. And you get $50. And now you're tied with Ellen. Wartime songs are identified with the war during which they were popular. Here are three such songs. Pick one and tell me with which war they're identified. Look at the screen. Praise the Lord, Yankee Doodle, over there. Which war are they identified with, Ellen?
Praise the Lord, I believe it's World War I.
I'm sorry, that's not right, Sam.
Yankee Doodle, World War I.
That's not right, Glenn.
Over there, World War I.
You finally got it, that's right. Now let me explain with the other two. Praise the Lord and Pass the Ammunition was World War II. And Yankee Doodle was from the American Revolutionary War. And you get $50, Glenn, and you've taken over that lead. No one likes a traitor, and no one likes to claim one. However, there are three traitors infamous in history. Pick one to name the country that he betrayed. Look at the screen. Benedict Arnold, Pierre Laval, and Vidkun Quisling. Glenn.
Benedict Arnold, the U.S.
Correct. Sam.
Pierre Laval, France.
Correct. Ellen.
Quisling, Norway.
That's right. All three are right. All three get $10. Throughout the years, women have made their mark on the world. Here are three women who rose to the top. Pick one and tell me what profession she is famous for. Look at the screen. Rosa Bonheur, Dame Nellie Melba, and Yvonne Goolagong. Sam.
Yvonne Goolagong, tennis.
Right. Ellen.
Nellie Melba, opera or singing?
That's right. Glenn. Rosa Bonheur.
Acting.
No, she was an artist, a painter. And so Sam and Ellen are correct. They get $25 each. Old campfire songs never die. They always refrain from leaving. I'll give you the first line of three old standards. Pick one and name the song. Look at the screen. Gonna lay down my sword and shield. Alas, my love, you do me wrong. The sun shines bright. And what are they, Glenn?
Gonna lay down is down by the riverside.
That's down by the riverside. Sam?
Alas, my love, you do me wrong. My last girlfriend, I don't know.
Well, you're going to have to write your own song for her. Ellen.
Alas, my love is my favorite song, Greensleeves.
Oh, that beautiful Greensleeves. And the sun shines bright on my old Kentucky home was the third one. So two of them get right, and two of them get $25. The score at the end of the first round is Glenn, 170, Ellen, 145, and Sam, 95. We've got a long way to go. And get you together in the next round when they double the score. Find out something about them. Glenn, you are in the greeting card business?
Mm-hmm. Along with my husband, we have our own greeting card line.
Do you also make up the material that goes in the greeting cards?
I write them. My husband designs them.
You're not the one responsible for having me. People keep sending me cards with my name in them about, you know, things about me. I don't get a royalty.
It's not you. I'd send you a royalty.
Would you? If you used my name in a greeting card, do you have to pay me or am I public domain?
You're public.
Oh, so you can do anything you want with it. That's why they do what they do with
okay.
me. Yeah? Okay. How's business?
Good.
Good. Sam, you don't want to pay cash for your membership in Squash? What happened?
Well, unfortunately, my club went into receivership the day after I went in and paid cash for my membership. They just closed the doors on me. My locker was filled, and I haven't heard from them since.
Well, they waited until they got your money, and they closed down, right?
Exactly.
In other words, you got squashed?
No,
you didn't think of it. Alan, Willem, we won't talk to them.
Okay.
All right, Alan, now, what's your favorite game, poker?
Straight seven-card.
Seven-card poker.
Yes.
Did you ever go down to Vegas and play with those tough guys?
I have lost money in some of the finest places in the world. Yes, I have played poker.
Did you ever enter those national tournaments?
No, I'm not that good.
Well, what made good cards are good? How much of it is skill and how much of it is cards?
50-50.
Really? That much skill,
so.
Huh?
Yes, I firmly believe it. A lot of skill involved.
That's why I keep losing all the time.
Me too.
You too. Listen, you are three great contestants and only one for you winner. Let's see what happens in the second round. We double the stakes now so that you can make a nice comeback. Now, if three of you are right, you get $20. If two of you are right, you get $50. And if only one person is right to an answer, it's $100 and can change the whole game. Are you ready? Here we go. Bavaria is a well-known tourist region in West Germany. I'll give you three other well-known regions in Europe that tourists love to visit. Pick one and tell me what country you'd find it in. Look at the screen. The Algarve, the Cotswolds, and Brittany. Sam?
Algarve is in London.
Glenn?
Brittany, France.
Brittany's France, right, Ellen?
The Algarve, Portugal.
That's correct. And the Cotswolds in England. Very wonderful section to visit, too. Glenn and Ellen get $50 each. These actresses who are no longer with us will be remembered for their Oscar-winning performances in the movies I'm going to show you. Pick one name of the star who won the Oscar as Best Actress. Look at the screen. The one for A Streetcar Named Desire, Gaslight, and Born Yesterday. Ellen.
Gaslight, Ingrid Bergman.
That is correct. Sam.
Streetcar Named Desire. The only person I can think of is Anne Margaret.
No, she's still with us. Thank you. Glenn.
Streetcar Named Desire, Vivian Leigh.
That's right. And Born Yesterday, Judy Holliday. The two girls are moving away from Sam. We talked about the Ivy League a few moments ago, what cities they're in. I'm going to ask you a different question about them. Four of them use an animal as their nickname for their teams. Just three on the screen now. Pick one and name the university. What team is it called? The Tigers? Which ones are the Bulldogs? Which ones are the Lions? Sam?
Nittany Lions.
From what school? And incidentally, that's not the Nittany Lions. I just asked you for the name of the school.
Oh, name of the school.
All right. And you haven't got it. I'll explain why later. Glenn?
Princeton Tigers.
Princeton Tigers is right, Ellen.
I'll take a guess. Harvard Bulldogs.
No, it's the Yale Bulldogs, and it's the Columbia Lions, and the Nittany Lions are Penn State, which are not on that list, but I just thought I'd throw that in. All right, so what happens now? Glenn, the only one who got an answer? $100. Glenn has the lead. Alan is second. Sam is third. I'll show you part of the titles of three old favorite songs. What's missing in each title is the name of a lady. Give me the lady's name that's missing in the title of these songs. I'll take you home again. Someone with light brown hair, and oh my darling, you should get these, Ellen.
I'll take you home again, Kathleen.
Correct. Glenn.
Oh, my darling Clementine.
Right. Sam, who is with the light brown hair?
Georgia with the light brown hair.
No, not Georgia. She may have had light brown hair, but this is the one, the genie, that we talk about in song. You know, Sam, you're having a tough time in this round. The two girls are just making mincemeat out of here. Come on. Sam, let's get back in the old game. In history and geography classes in school, we all learned the names of the great explorers of the past. Now, let's see what we remember. Here are the first names. Well, here are the last names. You give me the first names. De Leon, Balboa, and Pizarro. You give me their first names. Glenn.
Ponce de Leon.
Ponce de Leon is right. Ellen.
Francisco Pizarro.
That is correct. Sam, Balboa's first name.
Victor.
You might just as well say Georgia again. No, it's Vasco. And so Glenn and Ellen get another $50 each. And look what the score is. 470, 345, and 475. I'm going to show you the names of three well-known comic strip characters. Pick one and give me the name of his girlfriend. Look at the screen. Bam Bam, Sluggo, and Tubby. Ellen.
Bam Bam is Pebbles.
That's right. Glenn.
Sluggo is Nancy.
That's right. Here we go with Sam again. Tubby.
Georgia.
No, it's Little Lulu, but I figured out that if you keep saying Georgia somewhere in this show, that's got to be the right answer. Glenn and Ellen, okay, you get $50 each. I have three K words for you, okay? What I want you to do is tell me whether the items identified by these words that begin with the letter K are animal, vegetable, or mineral. Here they are. They all start with K. Krill, Chris, Crate. And Sam. Animal, vegetable, or mineral? Pick one.
Chris is a mineral.
That is correct, Ellen.
Crate is a vegetable.
Crate is not a vegetable. Glenn.
Krill is a vegetable.
No, the two girls are wrong because they're both animal. And look at Sam, he gets $100 all to himself. Let me quickly tell you that krill is an animal. It's a small crustacean. Kris is a wavy-bladed Malay dagger, and krait is an Asian poisonous snake, just for future reference. All right, now that Sam got $100, he's feeling better, and we go on to the next question. Millions of dollars have been spent on slogans to promote the sale of different beers. Sam, this could be yours. Here are three of those popular slogans. Pick one and name the beer. Look at the screen. Give me a light. It's the water, the champagne of beers. Glenn, pick one.
Give me a light of Miller Lite.
Sorry, Sam.
The champagne of beers is Coors.
Sorry, Ellen.
Give me a light, Labatt.
Nope. Here's what it is. Give me a light is Bud Light. Not just light, but Bud Light. Remember the way you always give them the wrong light? It's the water that makes the difference was Olympia water, and the champagne of beers has always been Miller. So nobody scored on that one. At the end of the second round, let's take a look at the score. Glenn has 520. Ellen, 395. Sam, 195. And it's not over, Sam, because the countdown round determines who goes to the car. Even if you're trailing in the money department, you can still come from behind to win the chance to go for the car. Because this is the countdown round. The questions are just as before, but this time when you buzz in, you may answer one, two, or all three parts of the question. Every time you're right, you count down one. The one to zero first will be the winner in this little horse race, but it's a handicap race. How many do you have to answer? Well, that person with the most money is Glenn and has to answer only four questions. That's Glenn has to answer four questions. Put up a four for Glenn. Ellen is second, she has to answer five questions, and Sam, being in the last position, will have to answer six, but you can still do it. Are you ready? Here we go. Italy is one of the leading tourist countries in the world because it houses some of the greatest art treasures in the world. I'll name three of those art treasures. You tell me in what Italian city you'll find them. Look at the screen. Da Vinci's Last Supper, Michelangelo's David, and Michelangelo's Moses. Sam?
Da Vinci's Last Supper in Rome.
Sorry, that's not right. Glenn?
Michelangelo's David in Florence.
You may continue.
Moses is in Rome.
That is right. You may continue. Da Vinci's Last Supper
is in Milan.
That is right. All three of them are right. And Glenn goes down to one. Now, Glenn, you just need one to win the game. The others are trailing by quite a margin. See if they can stop you. A number of historical mothers and fathers were parents of equally famous offspring. I'll name one of the parents. You name the famous offspring. Look at the screen. The queenly daughter of Anne Boleyn, the son of Philip of Macedon, the queenly daughter of Catherine of Aragon, and Ellen is in first.
The queenly daughter of Anne Boleyn is Elizabeth I.
That is correct. You may continue.
The queenly daughter of Catherine of Aragon, Mary, Queen of Scots.
Right. And one more to go. Son of Philip.
Of Macedon is Alexander the Great.
All three are right. You score three big points. Now we've got a close match at hand because Glenn still needs one, but Ellen only needs two. Sam still needs six. In school, we all learn the scientific names given to animals who eat meat or plant or both, huh? I'll tell you what the animals eat. You pick one and give me the word that ends in V-O-R-E. That describes the eating habits of that type of animal. Look at the screen. The one that eats chiefly plants, both flesh and plants, and chiefly flesh. Sam?
Eats both flesh and plants is a herbivore.
I'm sorry, that's not right. Ellen?
Eats chiefly flesh is a carnivore.
That is correct. You need one more.
Eats both flesh and plants. Gone.
And Glenn, sure. You still need one.
Eats both flesh and plants, omnivore.
You've got yourself a victory. The one that eats chiefly plants is a herbivore. The one that eats both is an omnivore, and the one that chiefly flesh is a carnivore. And so Glenn has to make a rapid finish there to win her championship, which she does. Sam, thank you for being with us.
I hope you
find Gloria somewhere.
Georgia.
Is it Georgia?
Georgia.
Oh yeah, Georgia's the one that has your share the money from the Squawk Society. 195 for you. And Ellen, 395 for gold. Play poker with us. Say it. Oh, you're a great favorite at all. Glenn, come with me. You have a chance of winning that car. And there is Sheridan waiting for you with a beautiful blue dress and a beautiful blue car.
This exciting car. Pontiac Firebird Formula can be won by Glenn Teichman right after this. Automobiles for the staff of Split Second provided by Ontario Rent-A-Car. For dependability and reliability at a reasonable price, big or small, we rent them all, Ontario Rent-A-Car. Accommodations for Monty Hall and the Split Second staff provided by the Toronto Hilton Harbor Castle, Toronto's only downtown hotel on the lake, featuring first-class dining and the award-winning Chateau Neuf, the Toronto Hilton Harbor Castle. The car featured as today's big prize on Split Second was provided by Addison Cadillac, the leading General Motors dealership in downtown Toronto. Addison on Bay, Sherilyn's Wardrobe by Winston.
Well, Glenn, this is the beautiful automobile that you're going to try and win right now. Sandy will describe it.
Monty, that's the sporty Pontiac Firebird Formula, equipped with all of Formula's standard features, like the fuel-injected V8 engine, cruise control, and AM-FM stereo cassette player, plus automatic transmission and air conditioning.
All right, Glenn, here's the way you have a chance to win the car. Behind us, we have five split-second screens. Behind three of them, words car appear, just like on the last show when the person picked the right three screens and won the car. You get three choices. If you get the car each time, three out of three, you're going to get yourself that beautiful automobile. If not, there'll be a lovely vacation in store for you, and you'll have a decision to make. And where is that vacation to, Sandy Hoyt?
Well, we're going to fly you and a companion to Paris, France, where you'll stay at a first-class hotel, and from there visit all of Paris's famous landmarks, from the Eiffel Tower to the Louvre.
I'll let you think about that, but now we're going to choose the three screens and see how well you do in your selection. Give me the three screens.
One, two, and four.
Let's take a look and see if there's a car behind one. Is there a car behind number one? There is. So let's move along and see if there's a car behind two. Is that the next one? Two. And two says vacation. And does it, where were the others while we're at it? Because there were two other cars just behind those screens. Let's see the three around. They were behind four and five. You had two of the four there. The vacation, the trip to Paris, and $1,000 in cash can be yours if you want it, if you want to take it and leave the show. Otherwise, you can come back tomorrow and try and win again for the car.
I'm going to try again.
You're going to come back tomorrow and try for the car. Thank you. Good to see you on our next show. And our guest, congratulations to you for today's victory. We'll see you all next time around. This is Monty Hall saying goodbye. From all of us, it's good to
Limited.